these like, what's that? Like the cedar wax wings.
Tomorrow we'll have some other things going on as well, but tonight we're kind of fortunate that we have Dwight Landis with us. And what I'm going to do before we get started with Dwight, Dennis, who's the proprietor and owner of Seven Mountains Campground, had a couple things he wanted to speak about in regards to fly fishing for us.
Welcome everyone. Give you a little bit of background here. My home's in Hershey, and my background is landscape architecture and horticulture. Right now in that section of Spring Creek, that's prohibited to be fished because it's in the park, it's in the borough, and so forth.
And basically Spring Creek Canyon, what they call the canyon, is between the hatcheries, from Better Spring Hatchery down to Fisherman's Paradise and the Belfont Hatchery.
The lower access point is the Fisherman's Paradise. You just park at Fisherman's Paradise and walk up. And there's a gated road, you know, that makes it very easy to walk up through there. And it's roughly 3.5 miles in between. You see on the map, there's a road that comes in from the Benner Pike in the middle, but you can't drive that road. That road's closed and it's going to remain closed. The interesting thing about Spring Creek Canyon is that that's not a traditional name. The people in our area didn't call it Spring Creek Canyon traditionally. They just talked about it as, you know, go to Paradise and fish up, or go to Benner Spring and fish down. The name Spring Creek Canyon came about in the 90s. If you think of Spring Creek below Belfont and above Belfont, there's a lot of differences between those two sections. For one thing, below Belfont, it's a much larger stream. The other thing is, like, after a high flow, for example, you get a lot of rain. If it's high below Belfont, you may want to fish above Belfont because it's just a smaller stream up there, a little more manageable. No green drakes yet, but there's a woman at Penn State who's trying to introduce green drakes. She's been doing this for a couple of years. She's getting it over at Penn's Creek and putting them in at the place called The Rock, which is at above the Benner Spring Hatchery. So if anybody sees any, let us know. So maybe someday we'll get it back. It'd be pretty exciting, I think. The one that most people know is McCoy Dam. It's a bigger dam, and more recently it was removed. But the one before that was down by the power substations, or just above the power substations down at Milesburg. That dam was lower dam, and the really good holding water for that dam was the pool behind the dam. It had a nice pool behind the dam. The other really good spot there was up around the bend at the gas station, and that water was backed up, and there's a huge pool at the bend at the gas station like that. Now, when they proposed taking the dam out, there were some of us that didn't think it was that good of an idea, including me. And Joe Humphreys was very much opposed to it. And what I told him was, if you pull the dam, the habitat's going to get worse. Well, that's another issue. That's a more recent thing. There was a chemical factory near the mall, Nice Chemical, and their method of treatment for their effluent was to dig a hole behind the factory and run it right out into the dirt there, and that was kind of it. It wasn't all that long ago, you know, didn't seem that long ago, 15 years ago, I guess. I walked up there by that spring. You could smell that stuff just coming out of that spring. There's nothing to knock you down. But that's how Spring Creek became a catch and release wild trout stream, is because of those chemicals. I fished the whole upper half of Slate Run, just a big, like an Adams or a March Brown, but like a size 10, and just slayed them and caught one fish after another. And then and those big browns will come out under those conditions. Like when it's real low and clear, they're landing, they're hiding. And since that time, I've started using stimulators, but also just big March Browns, anything big and shaggy. So try that, and you'll learn what lives in those creeks. So that's the way. This is as good as electrofishing, you know. Thank you all very much. I hope you all have a good evening.
Thank you.
There's a tear in my ear, oh, I'm crying for you still. You're on my own. Into these last 9 years, I'm getting. I'm gonna keep drinking until I'm petrified. And then maybe where you leave my eyes, there would be a place for my pride for you.
Hi, this is Dave Kyle with PA Flyfish. We're here at the 2012 PA Flyfish Spring Jamboree. I want to thank everyone for showing up for the weekend. We've got about 70 guys coming in from all over the state and all over the region, fishing Penns Creek, Spring Creek, and Little J. Again, I just want to thank everybody for coming in for the weekend. I hope everybody had a really good time and a lot of fun between catching some fish, meeting up with some old friends. So thanks a lot. Taking delivery of my new boat from Tim Murphy this morning. Pretty excited about it. Made by a company Tightline, Andy, representative for people in Europe that he's selling a lot to. They want the titanium, they want the gold plated, they want all the funky stuff. So that's what he's making over there. Yeah, it's just a spool that Tightline makes.
It's an old wood
cleaner. Does everything himself, from the anodizing. He can do engraving on the. If you want something special on it, you can engrave on it.
Cody and Sea Salt. It melts so easy and oh man, is it good.
Change my direction. Now there. That was a tailing tendency because I started my stroke too fast.
You know what? This is ridiculous. Sulfur dry, size 14.
26 fish?
Yep.
From 4 o'clock on.
I have iced up peacock black.
Don't need anybody saying
I made some of each.
Tying is sulfur merger. I'm gonna do some fishing and meet up with fellow fishermen and have a good time.
Yonder. the hair on. I believe I'll go up yonder, way over yonder, up on the hill. If my baby don't love me, maybe, maybe her sister Lucille will. Or slide guitar. Either or a little each.
I'm the owner and operator of the Feathered Hook here in Coburn, Pennsylvania, right on the banks of Penn's Creek. And it's May, so it's Green Drake time. The Green Drake is coming off. It's a pretty heavy hatch right now, and even though the water's up and off color, the bugs are still hatching, and the fish are still coming up and eating it. It's one of the things you learn about the Green Drake. It's a big enough bug and a serious enough food source that they're going to come up and eat it almost no matter what the water conditions are. Thank you.